Hello, this is the luckiest maths teacher in the world. Thank you so much for tuning into this video on inequalities. So inequalities work very similar to equations, and I'll show you that in a second. But first, we need to get comfortable with what inequalities actually are. So remember, if you have something like this, 4 and 3, we have these weird sort of arrow-like symbols. Remember, the crocodile always wants to eat the bigger number. Okay, so this symbol here means greater than. So greater points to the right. To the left means less than. And of course, if I add this little line here, it means greater than or equal to. And I can do the same for less than. So less or equal to. So you really need to be clear as day about these symbols. Because if you don't get the symbols, then doing these questions will be really, really hard, okay? So here is a statement, 4 is greater than 3. But of course, we're going to look at ones that involve letters again. So this statement here means x is less than 3. It just means x is a number less than 3. So what we can do is we can graph all the solutions on a number line. We can display this with a picture. So remember, number line is just one line and it has, you know, a whole heap of numbers. So I just put 0, 1, 2, 3. Number line goes on forever. And of course, on this side of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. And it goes on forever. Okay, so I can show, I can graph all of the numbers that are less than 3. I do that with a line. So I start here at 3, put a circle. And then the line goes forever in one direction. So technically it's a ray, okay? So this here, this line I've just drawn, shows, if I put an X there, all the numbers where X is less than 3, okay? So just so you know, if we have an open dot, that, so it's not colored in basically, that means less than or greater than. It doesn't include that number because 3 is not less than 3. So that's what this circle being open, not shaded, means, that it doesn't include this number down here, 3. Okay, if I want to include that number, I close the circle, I shade it in, and that'll mean less than or equal or greater than or equal. Okay, so I'm going to do it in another color now. In green, I'm going to graph x is greater than or equal to minus 1. So it's the same idea, but now I want to color in because I want to include minus 1, and it's all of these numbers here. So all of the numbers on that line, all the numbers, sorry, below that line, they are greater than or equal to minus 1. Because when we solve these inequalities, we're going to have to graph our solution the way I just did on a number line. So let's look at some examples. So I'm going to get rid of all the writing I've done here. Please pause and copy down if you need it. So we want to be able to solve inequalities like this. 7x minus 5 is less than or equal to 30. Okay, so the difference between this and a normal equation, well, there's actually infinitely many solutions. There are so many numbers that you can substitute for x that will make this statement true. So x equals 1 is a solution because 7 times 1 minus 5 is less than or equal to 30. 2 is a solution because 7 times 2 minus 5 is less than or equal to 30. A half would be a solution. X equals minus 2 would be a solution. So there are so many solutions, we need to categorize them all. Not all numbers will work. If I, for example, put the number x equals 6 in there, it won't work because 7 times 6 minus 5 is not less than or equal to 30. That's wrong. 7 times 6 minus 5 is 37, clearly more than 30. So the way that we're going to find all these solutions is heating this. We're going to use the same process as for equations. So what that means is we're going to undo everything that's been done to x in the opposite order to body mass. So here I'm going to add 5 to both sides. So I'll get 7x minus 5 and 5 cancel out is less than or equal to 30 plus 5, which is 35. So then we undo timesing by 7 by dividing by 7. So 7x divided by 7, 35 divided by 7, keep the same inequality. So what this means is the solutions to this inequality here are any number where x is less than or equal to 5. So I'm going to display that on a number line. So I can just draw it roughly. So you can, I'm sure, do yours much nicer with a ruler and pencil. So we have the number line here. I can display all the solutions by drawing a line. X is less than or equal to 5. So because it's less than or equal to, it includes 5. Close dot. And I go this way. Okay? How easy is that? So there is one exception. We do one thing slightly differently to equations, and that's when you have to reverse the inequality. So I'm going to show you an example of that now. So let's go ahead and do this example here. So it's the same process as for equations to start with. So this is a positive 12. So to get rid of it, I need to subtract 12 and cancel out. So of course I have to do that from the other side as well. So I get minus 3x is greater than 18 minus 12, 6. Now, I want to get x by itself. It's being times by negative 3. So to undo that, I need to divide each side by negative 3. Now, because I'm dividing by a negative number, I need to reverse the inequality. So the negative 3s cancel out, and I'm left with x. 6 divided by negative 3 is negative 2. But instead of greater than, it's going to point the other way. So the solution is actually x is less than minus 2. So that means that if I substitute any number for x that is less than but not including minus 2, it will make this a true statement. So if I want to draw up my number line again, yours I'm sure will look much prettier. So minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, that's of course 1. So to display this on the number line, I go to minus 2. I use an open dot this time because I'm not including minus 2, and less than, it's going to point to the left again. So I'm done. So there's only one more quick thing I need to explain to you. So please pause and copy this down if you need. So just so you're not confused, I better explain to you what happens if you see something like this. Okay, so we have our x values. So it includes 2. So it includes numbers that are less than 2 here, but they have to be more than minus 1, and we're not including minus 1. So the way you would write something like this, so you want x to be less than or equal to 2. We want to include 2. We want it to also be more than minus 1. So we want minus 1 to be less than but not equal to x. So the way you read this is x is between minus 1 and 2. It includes 2 but not minus 1. Okay? So I just thought I'd better explain that to you. All right, hope you've enjoyed this video. This has been the luckiest maths teacher in the world. Have a great day.